who I needed to talk to. Hello. Hello, flying dinosaur bug. Times in a row? That was cheap. Okay. We're in trouble here. Stop going twice in a row, you pizza monkey! Damn it! Wrong buttons! I'm gonna die. Yep. Wow. Load. That was Bull Pocket, and I guess now I have to go back and level up. Thank you. so full there. I might need to go over here. Let's take away. Dang it, come on. Oh, here we go. Return. Return. One more time. Okay. Yes. Skip. We already saw this. Dick. Luckily you're not doing any damage. You, on the other hand, full power. Come on, baby. There we go. Oops. Come on. Gotta stop missing these. You blocking bugger. Okay. Right. George Sand was an extremely famous author in Paris who had already published numerous books. Her real name was Aurore Dudevant. George Sand was her pseudonym. From 1838, Chopin would share his life with her for a long period, but when they first met, he commented to a friend, "Is that really a woman?" Sand was a somewhat masculine woman who wore pants and smoked cigars in public. Even her pseudonym, George Sand, was masculine. She was unswayed by society's mores, and expressed herself unabashedly. I missed that one. Of course, Chopin himself was also famous as a pianist in Paris by this time. Paris. The relationship between the genius pianist and the popular author must surely have been the talk of the town. At the time, Chopin was not in the best of health, and perhaps the attention paid to them by society aggravated his condition. During this time, Sand took Chopin to the Spanish island of Mallorca, to allow him to rest. To avoid attention, they left Paris separately and rendezvoused at a village near the border. They found a place to live on Mallorca, and Chopin lived a happy life amongst the palm trees, orange trees, and pomegranates. Chopin's health appeared to be improving, but the island entered its rainy season, and the warm weather vanished. Chopin caught a cold that eventually led to a relapse of tuberculosis symptoms. At the time, tuberculosis was a terminal illness, and Chopin and San's landlord evicted them, fearing contagion. After being forced from their home in 1839, Chopin and Sand arrived in the Vaidemusa Monastery. I'm not sure if I pronounced that right. And rain continued to fall outside. Sound of falling rain continued incessantly, the simple sound of raindrops blended together to form a dreary rhythm. It was under these circumstances that this song is said to have been born in a room in Vaidemusa. Created by Chopin at age 29. Journey to find rest ironically resulted in the worsening of Chopin's health. But George Sand devotedly stayed by Chopin's side, never fearing infection. There's little doubt that she was an invaluable source of comfort for Chopin. Guys didn't expect to get a history lesson, did you?
No. Rain makes the plants look even more alive.
Did you know those flowers? The rain is a blessing from heaven.
Technically, that's everywhere, not just Tenuto. Alright, let's see if we've got any upgrades for these two. Sword, what's that? Blade, attack up. Well, since he... Oh, bamboo shaft is better, good. Since he doesn't have anything equipped yet, we'll do that, good. I don't think I can change these out yet. Oh, I can!
Just one step.
pumping up in difficulty a little bit here already. Pretty clothes.
Creatures.
Ah!